Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this part, we want to challenge ourselves and take a test to review what we have learned so far. We have 15 three choices questions from previous sessions. Please read each one carefully and write down the correct answer for yourself, and pause the video if the question time is short. Finally, we will examine the correct answers together, and you can also find the correct answers in the description. Please write your score in the comments section and share it with others. If secure text entry is true, the text input obscures the text entered, so that sensitive text like passwords stay secure. The default value is false, and this doesn't work when multiline is true. Parsable is a core component wrapper that can detect various stages of parse interactions on any of its defined children. The dialog's title is required inside alert method, but passing null or empty string will hide the title. The transparent prop determines whether your model will fill the entire view. Setting this to true will render the model over a transparent background. Contained resize mode scales the image uniformly, so that both dimensions of the image will be equal to or less than the corresponding dimension of the view. Edge width allows for defining how far from the edge of the content view the sweep gesture should activate. Expo can use TTF and OTF font formats on all platforms and can use other formats on some platforms. Async storage can only store string data, so in order to store object data, you need to serialize it first. For data that can be serialized to JSON, you can use JSON.stringify when saving the data and JSON.parse when loading the data. Using the open database method, a database file with a defined name and location is searched. If the database file with that specification is found, it opens, and if it's not found, it opens after creation. Punks are the recommended middleware for basic Redux side effects logic, including complex synchronous logic that needs access to the store, and simple async logic like AJAX requests. React Native provides the Fetch API for fetching data from remote servers and APIs. It's quite similar to the browser APIs, such as Fetch and XML HTTP request. The API is promise-based, so you can also use it with the async await syntax. Channel ID and message are required to display local notifications in Android, and the rest of the properties are optional. In a region object, the latitude and longitude specify the center location, and latitude delta and longitude delta specify the span of the viewable map area. React Native Camera Hooks provides you with functionality to use the React Native Camera API with functional components. Snapshot tests are a very useful tool whenever you want to make sure your UI does not change unexpectedly. A typical snapshot test case renders a UI component, takes a snapshot, then compares it to a reference snapshot file stored alongside the test. The test will fail if the two snapshots don't match. Well, I hope you got a good result. Please write your score in the comment section and share it with others. Well, the fundamentals in this series have been completed, and from the next session, we will build an application together to upload to the store. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next session.